Let's talk about identifying redox reactions. And to do that, we must first know how to determine the oxidation number of an atom in a compound or an ion. So let's look at five simple rules that we can use to determine the oxidation number of any atom in a molecule or formula unit. The first is hydrogen is plus one with nonmetals. And so for HCl, methane, CH4, any compound in which hydrogen is bonded to a nonmetal, it's going to take a plus one oxidation number. And then with a metal, such as sodium hydride or potassium hydride, it's going to be minus one when in an ionic compound with a metal. Okay, oxygen's always going to be minus two, for example, H2O. Hydrogen's plus one, oxygen's minus two. They balance out to a zero overall charge for the compound and oxidation number, except when oxygen is in a peroxide bond. So in peroxide, O is minus one. Okay, and so if we look, that would mean hydrogen's rule is predominant. So plus one here, we would need a minus one and a minus one to balance out the overall charge to zero for H2O2 or hydrogen peroxide. So anytime oxygen is in that arrangement, it's going to be minus one instead. Common ions are the oxidation numbers equal to their ionic charge. So like we showed with HCl, Cl is minus one, hydrogen is plus one because it's with a nonmetal. Okay, fluorine minus one, oxygen minus two reinforces that, but any common ion is going to be its ionic charge for its oxidation state. Also calcium chloride, so calcium would be 2+, its oxidation number is also 2+, chlorine minus one, its oxidation number minus one. And then elements in their natural state are zero, so oxygen gas, nitrogen gas, all the atoms in an element's natural state are zero, so sodium solid, okay, its natural state is solid metal and it's zero. Okay, phosphorus P4 would be zero, sulfur S8 all zero. So let's look at a couple of examples. That's the best way to learn these. And if we find the oxidation number of carbon and carbonate, we know that carbonate is CO3 2-. So the way we do this is we say, well, the charge overall is 2-, and that's going to be equal to, let's give ourselves some room, so 2- is going to be equal to carbon plus three oxygens. All right, our rule says oxygen is always, we can say negative two, so we're more like an algebra equation here, minus two, oxygen's always minus two, so three times minus two. And if we solve here, putting carbon on the left side, we can minus six plus six to both sides to balance this out, so negative two plus six would be plus four for carbon in carbonate. So the oxidation number is plus four. What about the oxidation number of chlorine in perchloric acid? So in an ionic compound, chlorine takes minus one, but in a molecular structure, we have to be more careful. So perchloric acid means we take perchlorate, ClO4 minus, and match it with plus one hydrogen, and we've got our acid. Remember, acids are an aqueous solution, but for finding the oxidation number, turns out that won't matter. Overall charge of perchloric acid is zero, and we have hydrogen plus chlorine plus four oxygens. And so we know that hydrogen is always plus one. We're solving for chlorine, oxygen's always minus two. And so then, we're going to see if we solve for chlorine, plus one and minus eight there, and if we move everything to the opposite side, we would end up with minus seven goes to plus seven. So chlorine is going to be plus seven in perchloric acid. Okay, so definitely not minus one like it would be in an ionic compound. So be very careful with that. Okay. Identifying a redox reaction. Okay, so if we're going to identify this redox reaction, we have to be able to calculate those oxidation numbers. And the definition of a redox reaction is that the oxidation number of at least one element is going to change. So the simplest type of reaction would be an electrochemistry type process such as this. So we have chlorine, atomic chlorine gas, and we add an electron. Okay, this is a process you'll learn about later in the course, but we add an electron and we make chlorine minus. So chlorine goes from its natural state, an oxidation number of zero. We add an electron, it becomes an oxidation of minus one. So chlorine is reduced. Its number goes down. It becomes more or less. It becomes less, but it becomes more negative, which on a number line, anything that moves that way on the number line is going to be less. So 2 going to 1 is becoming less, and so that would be reduced as well. Okay, just as an illustration. But in this process, chlorine is reduced. What about a single replacement type reaction? So everybody knows if you react sodium with water, you get hydrogen gas that burns and creates a nice, sometimes a pop, sizzling sodium on the surface of water. Plenty of YouTube videos about that. But sodium plus water, we have a single replacement where hydrogen and sodium swap places. And so single replacement reaction. We talked about that in the types of reactions video. So what happens to sodium? Well, it's in its natural state here. It goes from zero, and then hydroxide overall is minus one, so that means sodium's an ion of plus one here, and when it's a simple ion, it has the same oxidation number as its charge. Okay, so we do have something going on with sodium. Hydrogen's always plus one when bonded with a nonmetal, and here it's bonded in OH. We know that it's a negative one charge. Oxygen's always minus two, and we add two to both sides, we get hydrogen's plus one, but we already knew that because it's with a nonmetal, okay? And so nothing changes with hydrogen there. However, hydrogen here is in its natural state, so at least some of the hydrogen is reduced, and we didn't balance the equation. We can do that now if we like, and so we can multiply by two here, and two here and two here, and we would balance the equation, but that's not going to affect whether we identify this as a redox reaction or not. Okay, what identifies a redox reaction is that we change the oxidation state of at least one element. And so we can also look at oxygen here as minus two, because it always is, and then it's minus two here. So oxygen doesn't change, so I'm going to remove that from our consideration, and let's look at what does change. So sodium and hydrogen change. So let's mark here. Sodium is said to go from a zero to a plus one, so it's going to be oxidized. It goes higher on the number line, so it gets oxidized. And then hydrogen, although it stays the same in hydroxide, at least some of it goes from plus one to zero. So it actually goes down, and so the hydrogen therefore is going to be reduced. Okay, and the thing that is reduced is the oxidizing agent. The thing that is reduced is the oxidizing agent. That's going to be water, is the oxidizing agent. And then the thing that is oxidized is known as the reducing agent, and that's going to be the sodium metal. Okay, so just a little terminology there, but this is indeed a redox reaction, and also could be classified as a single replacement reaction.